Hello friends, welcome back to my channel again. Today I'm going to tell you how to create a column layout plan or a center line plan of a G+2 residential building. So this is our ground floor plan, this is our first floor plan for the building, and this is our second floor plan. So first of all, copy this one. I had copied this one, this plan. Again, copy this plan also here. Okay. Now select here, select the whole plan. Now copy, then click here. Sorry, copy this CP, enter. Now click here and copy it here so that it overlap the other plan. Okay, now delete this one also, this one and this one also. Now similarly, copy this full plan and CP, enter. Now click here and just copy it here. Now delete this one. Now first of all, I have to delete all the external lines here. Okay, now this all the external lines I have to delete. Okay, now delete this line also, this one. Only column should be left here. Okay, delete all the lines. Delete all these ones, delete. Now delete this one also, this one, delete this one, delete. Now delete this one also, this one, delete. All the internal lines you have to delete, all the internal lines. Okay, only you have to left external lines and the columns should be left. And delete this also, I didn't want this line also. Okay, all delete this, all these ones, these dimensions also delete, all dimensions also. Now delete, sorry, delete this one. I'm deleting this one. Okay. This one also delete. This one. Delete all this stuff. Okay, delete this one also, this one, delete this one also, this one, delete all the lintel lines and only the column should be left. Okay, so I'm deleting all this stuff. Except columns and the outer line of the column should be left. Delete this one also here, select this one, Okay, so now all the lines have been deleted and I have to take an offset of this outer line. Select all the outer lines. Okay, now this also, this one also, and all the outer lines. Okay, so now take a offset of that is 0.5, enter. This one here. Okay, so now delete, we doesn't need these lines, so delete them. So like this, and delete this one. Okay, now delete this one also. Okay, so all lines have been deleted. Okay, now first of all you have to go to layer properties and create the layers such as grid. I have already created the layers. If you had not created the layer, then you should create the layer of grid or and circle layer and text and a dimension layer. And for the grid, you have to select the line type as center 2. I have selected here it as center 2. Okay, you can select it from going to, if you are now selected here, and go to load, and you can select here center 2 and click on OK. Okay, so now first of all select here grid layer. Okay, now L, enter, and just draw a line from center to center in the each column. Okay, okay, now L, enter, then this here. Okay, and L, enter, and this one. Okay, then L, enter, this line should be center to center joined to this column, and L, enter, then this column join here. Okay, now L, enter, and similarly for this columns to here, close it. Now L, enter, click on here and just, okay, now L, enter. Okay, now click here and close. L, enter. Now just click here and just add it. L, enter. Just click here and add it. L, enter. So here, without a column layout plan, we can't draw layout. Okay, mark a layout on the our field or our site where we have to construct the our structure. Okay, so it is necessary. Now here you have to extend this grid. Okay, so click on EX, then enter. Now select all of this stuff, select this line, select this line and this line, then click on enter. Now select this one, select this one, select this grid, this grid, this grid, here, then click here. Click here, then click here. Click here. Okay. So here it is not getting right, correct? Okay. There is a problem something. So you can join it here. And then just join here. Okay, L enter for this one. L enter. This is not joining here, so I have to click on L enter and this. Just trim it here. Okay, so I am trimming it here and trimming from here. Okay. Now delete all of this outer lines. We don't need this outer lines now. Okay. So their work have been done. Just delete it from here. Now click here and click here. Okay. Now this must also be extend, so click here and one L enter and just I'm extending here line. Click on L enter and I will trim it from here. Okay, so just I'm going to trim it from here, this one and this one. Okay, delete this one. Okay, so now all the grid lines have been created. Now go to a circle layer here. I will name these columns. So first of all, go to circle layer. Now click on circle here. Now click here. I'm making a circle. Now go to text. I will write a text here. That is DT enter and select here and somewhat this one. This one should be perfect. Okay, so A enter, escape. Now M enter. Now I want to click a text here. Now just copy this text. Okay, CP enter and copy it from here to all of this. Okay, so I will copy suddenly like that to all of them and I will name it. Okay, to here also I will copy. So just CP enter and from for the left side just click here, click this point and you can copy it. Okay, so after copying this it will look like that. Okay, and I will name it as 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 here and here 9 and here it is 10 and here it will I will name it ABCD on here also in bottom side and on top also I will name it as ABCD and on the right side I will name it as 1 2 3 4 again up to 10 here also same. Okay, now after this I will go to the layer that is known as dimension because I want to know the center to center distance between the columns also. Okay, so click on DIM dimension, that is. Okay, so now click here for dimensions. I am showing it here in the previous of that is rough I am showing here. So click on linear, just select this point and select this point and just you can mark your dimension. Similarly for the second also, just click here and click this point, again click this point and you can see here dimensions also, center to center distance also. So here you can see here that I have marked all the dimensions of this. Okay, so these dimensions have been marked. Similarly this is that is this column will be known as what, A1. This will be A1, this will be A2, and this will be A3, and so on. And similarly for this, this column will be named as B1, B and 1, which is B2 and B3, and so on. And similarly for this here, this column will be C1, C2 and C3 and so on. And for here will be D1, D2, D3, and so on. So these are the dimensions, and this is your column layout plan. So it is so important and very easy step to follow this and make a column layout plan. And without this plan, you can't go to the site and mark your layout, or either your construction can be made. So if you like it, seriously, if you like my video, then please do like, share, and don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, friends.